comic books and comic book history and the impact of comics on society and society on comics and how that plays out in the pop culture. It was fascinating stuff. And then I said, gee, are you going to be in L.A. the week of September 14th? And she said, well, yes, I am. And I said, awesome, and talked her into coming here. So we have an awesome guest speaker because the stars behind it are wonderful. If you are a guest and did not yet sign in, there's a clipboard back there. We want your name in blood and step into the pentagram and sign so there's binding. Like that. So without any further, I'm going to get out of the way, and we're going to hear about romance comics. So.
Use the mic.
Use the mic. Okay.
I mean, I've never really used the mic before, so I'm hearing it wrong, let me know. Okay, so I'm Sydney Heifler, and as you said, I'm a comic book historian, and I specialize in romance comic books from the early Cold War era, so late 1940s to the 1950s. I'm looking to expand. Right now, that's my general time frame. I'm about to go to Oxford to continue my research into British romance comic books. They're published during the same time period, so we'll see where that takes me. I'm kind of excited. But for now, I will be talking about American romance comic books. I've never really talked to a group that actually knows more about comic books than I do, so it's a little intimidating. So if you have corrections afterwards, please let me know. If I have guidance on my progress at UC Davis, my mentor only knew about the history. She knew nothing about